Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install IntelliJ IDE in your Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install IntelliJ IDE in your Windows 10, you need to have Java Jdk installed on your computer. So for that I have already made a video on how to install Java Jdk in your Windows 10 operating system. So I'll just first open my command prompt and I'll check whether Java installed on my computer or not. So for that, I will just type java space dash version, then press enter. And now see, Java version 15.0.1 has been directly installed on my computer. If you see some different messages like Java has not been recognized as an internal or an external command, something like that, then you just know that Java has not been installed on your computer. So for that, you need to first install Java on your computer. So I have already made a video on how to install Java. You'll get the link in the description also, and also in the I button. So you can click on that and just know how to install Java. But if you have already installed Java on your machine, then just simply go ahead with this video. So now that my Java has been rightly installed on my computer, so I'll just minimize that and I will just click on my Chrome browser, and in here I will type IntelliJ download for Windows. Yeah. Now the first link is from this www.jetbrains.com. So I'll just click on that. Yeah. And now I'll just simply cancel these cookies. And now there's basically two options. Now if you want to use the paid version, then you need to download this ultimate version, but you will also get a 30-day free trial. Otherwise, if you want to use the community version, which we are going to install on this video, so just simply click on this download option. Yeah. Now after clicking that, as you can see, this download has been already started. Now I'll just simply cancel this and I will just go to my download sections, as I have already downloaded this IntelliJ 2020 3.1 version. So I'll just simply cancel that. Yeah. And now in here, this is my downloaded file. So I'll just simply double click on it. And I'll just minimize this download folder. And now this installer has been launched. So just simply click on yes. Now this is this IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup wizard. So we just simply click on next. And this is the destination folder where this IntelliJ IDE is going to be installed. And you need to have a free space of 1.2 GB. And currently my available space is at 73 GB. So it's fine. If you want to change your installation destination, so just simply click on browse and you can change that. Otherwise, I'll just simply click this all default and I'll simply click on next. And now in here, they basically gave some check boxes. So for that, I will like to create a 64-bit launcher as a desktop shortcut. So I'll just simply click on that. If you are using a 32-bit, then you can click on this option. Otherwise, you just click on the 64-bit launcher, and I will just make this as a default path variable. So I'll just click on that. And now I would also like to add this as open folder as a project in my context menu. So I'll just click on that. And in this video, I'll also show you how to code a Java program. So I'll just simply click on Java, and now I'll simply click on next. Now I'll just simply keep this all default and I'll simply click on install. Now the installation has been rightly began. It will take a minute or two maybe. So I will just come back once when it gets done. So now as you can see, this IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup has been rightly done. And now it's asking two options, one to restart now, and if I want to restart it manually later, for which I would like to restart it now, because that will be a good option. So I'll just click on this reboot now and just click on finish. So now the restart has been begun, so I'll just come back when this restart is done. So welcome back. Now as you can see, this installation process has been rightly completed, and here is basically the IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition software. So I'll just simply double click on it, and here this IntelliJ IDEA has been launched and is asking whether if you want to import IntelliJ IDEA settings from your previous installation, for which I haven't installed IntelliJ IDE in my in this machine previously. So I'll just simply keep this do not import settings, and I'll just simply click on OK. Yeah, and now as you can see, this IntelliJ IDEA Community 2020.3 edition has been launched, and now here just click on a new project. Now as I have told you earlier, to install Java first. So if you have previously installed Java, then you will get this option. This is Java 15 version 15.01 over here. If you haven't installed Java, then you can download your Java from here, and you can also install here. Otherwise, as you have already installed Java, so you'll get this option. And now just simply click on next. Yeah. Now just simply check this create project from template option, and just click on this next, and in here give a project name, for which I will be writing Hello World, and I'll just this package name is com dot, I'll change this to Geeky Script, that is the name of our company. You can change this as per your wish, and I'll just simply click on finish. Yeah, and now it will load a few components, and it will give you a interface where you can write your code. First they will show you this tip of the day, for which I'll just simply click on don't show any tips and then close, and you can just ignore this update for now. That is this installation of Kotlin, because right now we will show you how to write a simple Hello World program in Java. So this is basically your project directory, so just open that and click on this drop down section, and in here in this src directory, this is the package name, that is this com.geekyscript, and in here this is your main class, that is rightly opened over here. This is this package name, and then this is your main class. Now in here, as they have shown already, write your code here. So I'll just simply write s out, and I'll just simply click on that for system.out.println. This is the benefit you get in IDE. You don't need to write much. So I'll write hello world, and I'll just simply click on the run button now. And now as they are showing, they are building it. That is, they are creating basically the class file at the back end. And now as they have shown rightly, this hello world. Now I'll show you how to create a class. So for that I'll just click on this package name, and I'll just right click and click on new Java class, and I will just name it a demo class. Yeah, and I'll just double click on class, and here, and as you can see, this demo class has been rightly created in your this com.geeky script. So in here I will just create a method, public void demo. Yeah, and now I will write s out hello world in demo class. So this is our demo class, and in here when we'll trigger this method demo, then it will show this hello world in demo class. And now I'll go to our main class, and I will just change this hello world in main class, so that we can recognize which hello world are they printing. And now I'll just create an object of our demo class, that is demo class DC new demo class. Now DC is our object, and I'll just click on DC dot, and this is the name of our method demo. So now it's done. I'll just simply click on this run button. And now as you can see, this hello world in main class has been rightly shown, and this from this demo class, this hello world in demo class has already been rightly shown. So that is how you install IntelliJ IDE in your Windows 10 operating system, and how to create a project, and how to, you know, create a class. I have shown almost everything. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and also please share with your friends. This is a new channel. It will help to grow our channel if you like this video and also share with your friends. And if you are subscribed, then also it will be a great. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.